This is Dr. Jyoti Bali from Baby Soon Fertility and IVF Center. We are showing you the procedure of egg collection, the ovum pickup. It is an important procedure in IVF cycle. After stimulating a patient for 10 to 12 days, the patient is given a trigger and then the patient is taken up for ovum pickup procedure. This is a very simple procedure and made it simpler by our anesthetists and the transvaginal sonography. Earlier it was done by laparoscopy when IVF began, but now transvaginal sonography, it can be done without any cut or suture on the body. The patient is here only for few hours in the hospital. They take care admission for 6 hours and the patient is discharged on the same day. So life has become more comfortable with these two technologies, ultrasound machine, which is transvaginal probe, and the anesthesia, which is a short GA called as twilight anesthesia using propofol. The advantage being quick entry, quick out for the patient and very, very comfortable. Unlike earlier, we used to give cervical blocks or local anesthesia, which was not comfortable for the patient and it was very painful also. But now the procedure is very, very comfortable. So let me show you from the Baby Soon IVF OT how it is done, how we can manage the patient very, very comfortably. This is the trolley that we set up. There is no antiseptic used before the procedure because that could be gametotoxic or toxic to the oocyte. So no betadine, only normal saline. The patient's vagina is cleansed only with the swab, with general thorough washing with normal saline only. And the trolley has minimum instruments like a speculum. We use a sterilized probe guide and not, there are disposable ones also. You can use whichever one you have. For today's case, we are using this sterilized probe guide, which is a metal one. And here a probe cover, which is non-spermicidal. This can be covered. For how the probe preparation is done, I will be showing you after we show you this trolley. So Chandar is here with me to prepare the IVF trolley here. These are the tubes in which the follicular fluid from the ovary is going to be collected. So how we connect here, the tube is connected to this setup here. This is a single gauge needle. It is a Cook's needle, which is 17 gauge needle, 35 centimeters long by Cook company, which we are using for today's pickup. And there are double lumen needles also. When the number of follicles are less than 5, there we prefer using double lumen needle, but this is a single lumen needle where I have stimulated a donor today and I'm doing a ovum pickup. So this is how the connection is made on the test tube here for collection. And there are multiple test tubes kept here. Once the tube is 2/3 full, we will pass it on to our IVF lab. And one side is connected from the needle to the tube. As I've shown you, the other side is connected here to a suction pump. And the suction pump is monitored by the foot pedal, which I will be operating by my foot from this side here while I am doing the pickup. So I will show you this after some time. So after the preparation of the patient and this side, the trolley is ready, we will now be preparing the probe. So I will request Chandar Bhaiya to come here and prepare the probe with me so that I can show you the probe preparation for ovum pickup. Chandar, please come. Payal, Dr. Payal, would you help me out? So Dr. Payal is here with me to assist me for this case today. This is a camera cover, sterilized one, which we are covering the whole probe with. You can take a sterilized cloth also. It is up to you, but this is a disposable one which we use, a separate one for each patient. Saline to be. For better visualization, we add a little saline and no other. So some saline added and the probe cover is being prepared. To which the needle will pass and it is a guided thing through the ultrasound machine visualization and you do the pickup. So I will be showing you the procedure. Or sit and do it. I have done both, but today I'll be sitting and doing it. It's more comfortable for me. I'm not showing the vaginal preparation, but I repeat, it is only normal saline which is used. No betadine, no antiseptic in the OT. It is gametotoxic. So here we begin. Focus on the ultrasound machine now. Before I begin the procedure here, I will check my needle. I will take some flushing media in the test tube and I will just press the foot pedal of the suction pump. And Chandar has to confirm whether did he get the flushing media? Yes, Chandar? Okay. So the needle is patent. I have flushed the entire tubing with the flushing media here. So now this is the, can you please show the screen? The ultrasound machine, can you please focus there? This is the right ovary that I have focused. Payal, this is a donor which we stimulated for 10 days on antagonist protocol. She has about 10 to 12 this side, more than that rather, intermediate follicles. If I count, there would be around 15 this side and 10 to 12 the other side. Yes, she's a donor stimulated for the clinic. And it was an antagonist protocol, a trigger, agonist trigger given to her for 10 days. And today is the 12th day of her cycle. And yes, we did, because to avoid ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome, that is the best protocol and the best trigger to avoid this complication. It's a OHSS free clinic then. Focus, ek udhar. Okay. So we have both the cameras on now. One will show the... So now this is the ovary that I have focused, and if you can see on the screen, there's a dotted line. That is a probe guide. To begin your pickups when you are initially learning, it's always better to put the probe guide on, and the principle being I'm holding my probe with the left hand, which has to be, there should be no space between the ovary, and you push it and you keep it snugly fitted in, and then your right hand gently going through the follicle. The principle being, be gentle to the tissue of the ovary, it will treat you well in return. So here I prick, and through one puncture in that same line of the probe guide, I will try and aspirate as many follicles as possible, and not for every follicle that I take a separate puncture. So by one puncture, if I can take as many as possible, well, that is the smooth procedure, gentle procedure, treating the tissue of the ovary well and not causing any injury. So shearing of the ovary should not happen. The needle should be well aligned along the probe guide, so that the ovary doesn't shear and bleed later on. Here, if you can see this focus on the screen there, usko closely focus karenge. So when you see the follicles being empty, you check the tube. Once the tube is two-thirds full, I will ask my assistant Chandrabhaiya to give the fluid filled tube to the lab. And it is passed on. Dr. Payal, could you please help us showing the pass window of the OT to the lab? It will be passed on to the embryologists in the lab, so they will search for... Yes, and they will search for the M2 oocytes there. The follicular fluid will be scanned by the embryologist sitting that side while we do the pickup. So every tube where it is two-thirds filled, it should be passed and the next tube taken. Our anesthetist, Dr. Mangla, he's done a fantastic job for us, always quick in and quick out of the OT with IVF. Smooth anesthesia, so the credit is Dr. Mangla's. This procedure looks very simple, but it does have its learning curve. So I change my plane, and once you're moving your probe, the needle should be out of the ovary once you want to focus. So if the needle is inside, it will certainly cause damage to the ovary and injury. So here I see some big follicles, and I go in this plane and I will take all in this line. But my left hand is holding the thing tight. The probe is tightly held. There should be no gap between the tissue and your probe. As tight as you can push it in and then do it. So the ovary is fixed. Here, this follicle is empty. I move to the next one here. You can see the tip of my needle along the probe guide being shown on the screen. Is it coming? Take it in right in the center. The filling is easier. Coming, Chandar? Yes. So the assistant needs to continuously say coming, coming and coming. The fluid is coming. If not, then please check the needle if it is blocked or what is wrong. Do I get to know the score from the lab? My embryologist to tell me the score, please. Okay, they found one oocyte there, so we can continue. This is the second, third follicle that I've taken. So once the follicle is empty, I have taken this line. So I will withdraw my needle, curated the walls of the follicle, taken my needle out, move the plane, and then I will take these bigger ones here. Coming? Light. Here. Here in the same plane, I go in the second bigger follicle here. Quickly. Coming. The pressure in the Cook suction pump to be kept at 100 to 110, not more than that. Can I know the score from the embryologist? Okay. Now, this is important. Screen pe focus karenge. See, now in this plane, if you see, there's a vessel running behind below the ovary. That is the identification, how you identify an ovary on transvaginal ultrasound. Sometimes when you take a plane, it looks like a follicle, rounded follicle. But then one must move the probe and see, with the needle being out, that you don't ever touch this vessel and the follicles. Just nearing it, you can even leave them. Or once experienced, you can do it gently. But you must identify the vessel below the ovary. This is the iliac vessel. This is the only complication one dreads while doing an ovum pickup. So God has been kind, I have never had it. But yes, this is during my learning curve, this was what we learnt. So here we've aspirated all the follicles from both the ovaries in this particular patient. See, there is some follicles which will look as if they have been left, but they are refilled sometimes. So when you aspirate them, it will only be causing injury and only blood will come out of it. So better not to take a second puncture. If you are sure you've gone systematic, there is no need to puncture them again. And just recheck that any follicle in any plane has not been left. A follicle above 16 millimeter in an antagonist protocol is likely to give you a mature M2 oocyte, and lesser than that, likely chance, but you can aspirate all that comes your way, and intermediate follicles also should be taken up and aspirated well. Now, after the procedure is done, you've checked the uterus, the lining, move your probe to see anything that is there. There should be no internal bleed. The anesthetist should be asked, sir, is the patient fine? Dr. Mangla? Yes. So then we take out the probe, flush the needle, so that if there's anything in the tubing, it goes back to the tube that is attached to the suction pump and the system and given to the lab. One must have a look at the vagina, put a speculum there and check any internal bleed. Can I have the OT light on, please? Normal saline, wash thoroughly in the vagina, check for any internal bleed there in the cervix or in the phonysis, and that needs to be managed so the patient is not bleeding afterwards. Yeah. And here I remove my speculum and I clean only with normal saline. Can I have a gauze? Normal saline, please. Betadine, even now after finishing the procedure, we never use any betadine in this OT because we are dealing with gametes. The follicular fluid contains the oocytes. So in the IVF OT complex, we don't do any other procedure except ovum pickup and embryo transfers here. Hysteroscopies and other procedures are done in the other OT. So betadine is never, never as a rule used in this OT. Thank you, Dr. Mangla. Thank you, Dr. Payal. Thank you, Chandar and Hari.